Hey guys, it's Pacifiers and Rollers here. Thanks so much for joining us for our first session of Sip and Chat, where we're just going to discuss our natural hair journey, just a question and answers with a couple of other guests, which may be a few questions that you guys have at home. I have two special guests here with me today. I have Tammy and Nadine. Thank you guys for joining us today. So our first question is going to be, how long have you been natural?
I've been natural for 7 years now. I had a perm and transitioned. I started like chopping off like little bits and pieces, and then I wasn't really comfortable wearing my like natural hair. Like I thought I looked like a little kid, so I wore the whole weave and wig stuff. Went through that phase, and then I was just like, you know what? I'm gonna just rock my own hair.
Definitely get it.
Never went back.
That big chop is definitely rough. It's like super short, right, and you're like, I'm not ready for this.
The first time I came home with my hair completely out, my dad said I looked like a crazy woman. Why would you do this? But I have been natural for 12 years, and I had a lot of heat and relaxer damage, which my hair was just kind of falling out, and I would braid it up, and I'd take the braids out, and I'm like, wow, you don't have many like relaxed strands left. So went in the mirror, and I just cut them up, and
Never looked back. Well, I've been natural for, let's say, almost 4 years now. I was definitely doing my perms every 2 months. Like, you could not get me past a week after the 2 months.
It's such a New York, exactly, Brooklyn, like, go to the Dominican.
Exactly. Right. Get that blowout from the roots.
Esperanza.
That's why the hair fell out, yes.
Girl, it was a struggle. Like, I loved my perms. It had to be super straight all the time. But once I would, like, get past that 2 month, it would be, like, time for a perm. But nonetheless, my cousin was my hairdresser, and she basically was like, you're perming your hair too often, like, you're gonna have to push it to, like, 3 months, and that was not happening for me. So I basically got my protective style, put in my weave, and, like, every 2 months, I could actually basically just change the weave, did it over again, and then after that, I was like, you know what, I've basically been transitioning for a while now, so took out the weave, and it was time for the scissors to come, and I literally was about to cry, but nonetheless, I love the natural hair, and I love my journey. It's been, like, amazing ever since, so. Wouldn't change it for the world.
Kudos. Yeah, same. Like, it's weird because whenever I look at pictures of myself as, like, when my hair was relaxed, I'm just like, I don't even recognize myself.
Right.
Because this has become so much a part of me and my story. And just, like, and I'm honestly, I just feel like, even when I have, like, my worst hair days, I still feel like I look so much better. My hair is so much thicker, so much fuller.
Exactly.
So much more me than it ever was when it was, like, straight and relaxed and just, bleh.
Totally get it. Not including wearing your natural hair at work. Which is definitely a struggle, and, like, I would go out with my hair, like, basically, I would basically have, like, a twist out, really straightforward, sleek, or my hair up in a ponytail, because I feel like doing different styles, you kind of look kiddish, and it's, like, it's not appropriate for the professional environment, but, like, you guys experience that?
That, and you don't want to, like, keep touching your hair, so I try to keep it, like, bare minimum.
Yeah. So. Totally get it. So, another question for you guys. What are your go-to products? Because I know it takes, like, a while for you to get that favorite product that you like that works with your hair. What about you?
I use Shea Moisture, and I also use Maui.
I never tried it, but I've seen it.
No, I'm trying to figure out, like, I heard you say that earlier. It's just like, is that the M-A-I-L-L-E?
No, it's the M-A-U-I.
Oh, there's a U in there. All right. Yeah. So I've seen their products. I've never...
Right. They smell so good. Now, so. And they make my hair so soft, so, well, my hair, not. But, yeah, I love it. Like, it smells good, so.
Nice, I have to try that one.
Yeah.
How about you?
I swear these days by Camille Rose. I was a Shea Moisture girl for a really long time, and I think over the years, one of the things I've had to learn is that products don't work forever.
Right.
And so within the past 2 years, like, Camille Rose has, like, literally been my go-to, as expensive as her products are, between just, like, the co-washes to the twisting gels to the moisture butter. It's just, like, I love it. My hair feels great. My hair responds to it. And I'm like, All right, girl, take my money.
Yeah. Let me see. My go-tos are the OGX coconut curl butter. Mm-hmm. Coconut oil is my everything. And, of course, that gel. Like, I layer that gel on. Like, my tube is, like, this big. Like, I don't do anything without gel.
So, like, for me, that's crazy because I always hesitate to use gel because I'm always afraid of, like, it flaking
or drying.
Right. And it's just like, but then what if I want to do something else? And because, yeah, like, I've seen your videos. I'm just like, oh, you use, should I start buying more EcoStyler gel? I bought.
Actually, EcoStyler gel does not work for me. Like, I find that it dries my hair out. So I started using the Flex.
maybe different products, like my gel, so many different things.
And that's
why
I feel like, because I'm just like, I really thought like gel was just a complete failure for me. I was just like, I'm not.
And then I bought two bottles because I watched a couple of your videos, and we'll see how that goes. Right. I have to donate those your way.
I like it. Let's see. So what hair type would you say that you have, and do you find that you prefer your hair type or other hair types that you see?
So I'm probably more in that 4C. I swear if there's a 5A, I'd probably be there too. Like my hair is just, no matter what I do, it just stays very tightly coiled. Like, you know, I do the stretch and I'm just like, oh, look at that, you got a little length today. And it's just like, boop. Like as soon as I'm out for like 5 minutes. So it's very much 4C. And it's a lot because it's like very stubborn, like, you know, because I watch these videos.
Right,
and I'm like,
yeah,
yes.
Yeah.
I'm like, all right, I'm going to use this product. I'm going to stretch it out. And then it's like, oh, I'm going to get some length. And no.
Yeah.
Like it literally poofs back up into like what it is today. This is like a stretched out for me.
Okay.
It's like, you know, I was like, no, it should be like here. But definitely like more 4C, just stubborn. And I mean, I've wanted like I was like, even if it's just a little 4A, it gets a little bit more length.
A little more curl.
Right.
I think I'm in between a 4B and a 4C. I feel like my hair is kinky. It's very thick. Like, I have to use so much product. Like, everybody on their videos are like, dime size on the finger. Yeah, no, I have to use a scoop. Okay, a scoop. But I used to kind of say that, like, I like the types that are a little bit more curly, a little bit more less tight. So I would say around, like, the 3C hair texture, because it's just, like, their hair is so easy to manage, so easy to part, like, that 4 section.
And they can do a real wash and go. I still haven't, like, perfected the wash and go.
Yeah.
I'm like,
ooh.
Yeah.
It's a lot of work. It's a lot of work.
I think I'm a 4A, 4B. Not sure, but I think that's what I am. I do like the threes. Because, like you said, like, they have that more of that, like, versatility. So, I do like that. But, like I said, I like my hair, too. So,
yay. It's a tough journey. It's a tough journey. It's just like,
yeah,
I love it now.
Yeah.
It's actually, like, 3 years ago. But
right.
Like,
3 years ago, I had a weave and a wig.
Which means, doesn't mean that she didn't love it. It's just, it was just a lot.
Right. It was
to maintain.
Definitely.
Totally. So what is one thing that you would like to see from the YouTubers and influencers, something different, something that stands out and pops that you don't necessarily see right now on the videos that you watch?
That's a stumper.
It's a hard one right now.
Just because we're talking about protective styles, I think one thing for me is being able to talk about, just because I have a wig or weave, like, personally, I don't like any of those. My head gets hot. Like, I don't partake in any of those, but I do, like, a lot of braiding. So I have, like, my faux-locs, and I'll have, like, braids. I'll just, and it's just easier to maintain. And I think we don't talk about the fact that just because you use a lot of protective styles doesn't mean that you don't like your natural hair or you don't love it or that it's not a part of you. It's just, listen, I have very limited time.
I get it.
And it is worth to, like, do this every day, every other day, manipulating, etc. But just if I got that wig, or if I'm gonna braid it up for 3 months, like in and out. And sometimes you just want
that time to just relax and just not have to worry about your hair and getting
and
it done.
Like, I hate that there's like this stigma that comes along with, like, oh, if you have a protective style or if you wear something else, you don't love your hair. No, I love my hair, but I also love being able to get out of the house in 20 minutes. Like,
get
it. I think for me, I would like for more influencers to talk about, like, products that actually work on your edges, instead of me having to, like, go to the store and buy these products, and I have, like, a whole thing of stuff on my shelf, and I'm just like, where is the progress?
Where is the progress? I need help.
And you mean, when you say edges, like, as in, like, growing them back?
Growing them back, yeah.
Because I can't.
Like, they're not completely lost, but they're, like, thinning, so I just want it to be, like, back at that stage where it looks, like, ooh.
Thick and full.
Yeah.
I get it. I mean, I basically kind of lost my edges because I did have a baby a couple of months ago, and I do feel like a lot of my hair has been falling out.
Mm-hmm.
So what I've been using is the castor oil, putting it like every 3 days or so on my edges.
Mm-hmm.
Not too heavy, not too light at the same time, just to hopefully restore it and see, you know, how long it'll take for it to kind of get back to what it was. So I think that was
recommendation. I got a Haitian castor oil product I like to use.
Sounds good. I like recommendations. Bring them over.
Royal Essence. Shout out Temple family. You know, I gotta shout out my alma mater. But a Haitian owned business. They use Haitian farmers, like, and it's like
I've actually heard of that name.
Crayon Essence. Okay. Telling the people to look it up.
So we're definitely going to use that. We're going to get that information, put that information in our description. But I think this was a great first session.
Yes.
Thank you guys so much for joining me and for answering the questions. Thank you guys for listening and watching our video today. Hopefully to see you guys for part